Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. Last Friday, Nakamura and Wesley So played the chess.com speeches final. The format of this online tournament is an exciting marathon, 90 minutes of 5 minutes blitz games, 60 minutes of 3 minutes blitz and 30 minutes of 1 minute bullet chess. So what happened? In the first 8 5 minutes games, Nakamura is on fire and is at 3 points, but we are going to watch together game 9. Let's see what happens. Nakamura with the white pieces opens with d4. Wesley So answers with knight to f6, and here comes bishop to g5. d5 now with knight to c3. We are in the Veresov attack. So knight to c3 looks strange because he's blocking the c pawn, but in the Veresov attack, white doesn't want to push c4. Instead, the Veresov is an attacking opening. White wants to push e4, and he wants to attack the king. Wesley So answers directly in the center with c5, so here comes e3. Now e6, and black is fine because if you watch this formation, this is a French opening, a classical French, but white, instead of having the central pawn on e4, has the pawn on e3, so black is perfectly fine. Here comes knight to f3, a6, same idea, a3, h6 attacking the bishop, and bishop back to h4. With knight in b goes to d7, Wesley So begins also to develop the queen side. Now bishop to d3 and b5. Short castle for white, bishop in fianchetto to b7, and knight to e5 clears the f-file for the pawn push and the king side attack. Now bishop to e7, f4, queen to b6, and bishop back to f2. Rook to d8, and now with queen to f3, Nakamura completes his development, bringing the queen into the attack. Short castle for black, queen to h3, so now Wesley So must react in the center. Knight to e4, attacking both this knight and this bishop, so knight captures, d captures, the pawn is protected by the bishop, and so bishop back to e2. After c captures on d4 and e captures on d4, in this position, probably black is better than white, but here comes knight captures on e5, that is a bit rushed, but of course it's rushed because this is a 5-minute blitz game, but just to find something better, let's go back one move, let's explore a different idea. Let's go back. In this position, knight to f6 with the idea of knight to d5 is strong, let's watch why. Now c3. Knight to d5 attacking the pawn, also threatening a terrible fork. So bishop to g3 with the rook and the bishop protecting this pawn, but here comes a5. Rook in a goes to c1 is one of the best moves. b5 is another strong and good idea because while the white pieces are quite restricted, after this pawn exchanges here on the queen side, the black pieces will gain a strong activity. Let's go back to our game. Instead, in this position, Wesley So he changes here on e5. Knight captures, f captures. Now, queen to c6 attacking c2. So here comes c3 and now f5. E captures on f5, the bishop recaptures. Bishop to g4 attacking e6. So bishop back to c8 protecting the pawn. And now, rook in a goes to d1. Here comes a5. Bishop to e3, so a new piece that is watching the castle. Wesley So continues with b4, but this b4 is now a mistake that opens the dangerous c-file. C captures on b4, a captures on b4, and here comes rook to c1, attacking the queen. Queen to e6, this is a good square for the queen, but the Veresov is a tactical opening, and white can play a winning move. Even if the game is a blitz, Nakamura is able to find it. Rook captures on c8, removing the defender of e6. Rook captures on c8, and now bishop captures on e6, we check, is also a fork. After, Wesley So continues with king to h8. So, what to do now? Is it possible to give the final blow with bishop captures on h6? Let's watch this variation first. Bishop captures on h6, not played by Nakamura, is tempting, but this capture is a mistake. And if Black is able to find this beautiful queen sacrifice, then Black will win the game. After queen captures on e6, fantastic defensive queen sacrifice, White is forced to capture, queen captures on e6, and now bishop captures on d4, comes with check. Of course, not king to h1, or this rook capture becomes checkmate. So, rook to f2, shielding the king is the only move. Bishop captures on f2 with check. King to h1, and now rook in c moves to e8, not only attacking the queen, but also supporting this important passpawn, and Black is winning. If queen to h3, king to g8, the position is completely winning for Black, it's -2. But Nakamura probably evaluates well this line, and after king to h8, he continues with bishop captures on c8, attacking the queen. Now, how to recapture, with the queen or with the rook? Wesley saw recaptures with the rook. White was already winning, but the most precise recapture is with the queen. Now, in this position, because the g7 pawn is overloaded, Nakamura can play another simple tactic. Bishop captures on h6, now king to g8, and now rook captures on f6. The g-pawn captures on f6 the rook, but after queen to d7, Wesley so resigns, because to stop the checkmate, Black must sacrifice this rook. Let's play some other moves. Only way to stop the checkmate is to play rook to c1 with check, but of course the bishop will capture the rook. Bishop captures, and now queen to e2, threatening checkmate. But with the checks, the white queen is able to move back. Queen to c8 with check. Now queen to c7 with check, king to e6, queen to f4, and white, that is a piece up, will easily win this endgame. With this great tactical game, Nakamura, after 9 games, is 4 points ahead against Wesley So, but if you think that the battle was over, you are mistaken, because this final was a real fight, and I will show you other 3 great games between Nakamura and Wesley So. I hope that you liked the video, and if you did, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel. For now, I thank you very much for watching, but see you soon. Goodbye!